champion is underway in a competition unlike anything you've seen before. A transformation of man and machine as giant mechanical wonders are piloted by their human counterparts. 12 teams from all walks of life have been brought together to compete for the ultimate prize.
I'm a two-time Olympian.
I'm a race car driver.
I work for NASA.
I'm a professional MMA fighter and the daughter of George Lucas.
I love you.
I love you too.
All bonded to their very own impressive metal warrior.
Oh my God.
With proper training.
This is a fully hydraulic humanoid robot capable of exerting 2,000 pounds of force.
Jeb. And team chemistry.
Oh my God.
You can't give up.
No,
we're not giving up.
Teams will advance through the tournament towards their ultimate goal. $100,000. And the title of the first ever champion of the Robot Combat League.
My job is to develop robots for NASA. The latest rover that we landed on Mars called Curiosity. I built that.
Hello, Jeffrey Fellin.
My name is Jeffrey Fellin. I'm a helicopter pilot for the California National Guard.
Hey, how you doing?
Hi, teammate.
Hello. To control these robots and fight other robots with them is definitely a really awesome opportunity they've given to me.
I'm George.
I'm Biano.
My name is Biano Kamani.
I'm a two-time Olympian.
My name is George Kirkman. I own my own business teaching kids about robots.
It's quite a ways from if we were working in a garage.
My name's Dave Chancel. I'm a software engineer at Intel Corporation.
My name's Amber Chancel. I work in the same building as my dad. My dad's been building robots for years, and I've kind of gotten involved in that with him.
I'm here to highlight how cool it is to be a scientist, how cool it is to be an engineer.
Jericho.
I grew up on wrestling, so when I first saw Chris Jericho, I was really, really excited to meet him, and I'm really, really excited to work with him in this competition.
I know a little bit about fighting, I know a little bit about competition, and I want to welcome you to a competition unlike anything the world has ever seen before. The Robot Combat League.
I make toy robots for a living. Yeah, I'd say I'm a big fan of robots.
A new generation of larger-than-life robot fighting machines will enter this arena and do battle controlled by you. You're all about to become superhuman. We have paired you up into teams of two. Each team consists of a Robotech, which will control the maneuvering of the robot and be the point person for all technical issues, and a Robojockey will be responsible for the main fighting. We have 12 unique robots. Each one will be specifically paired to your team.
Yes, it's like my childhood dream coming true. This is going to be awesome.
Now, these are amazing, intricate, futuristic fighting machines that are yours and yours alone. So get to know them because you're going on this journey together. But in the end, only one robot fighting team will emerge victorious and walk away with the grand prize of $100,000.
$100,000 is on the line, and obviously everybody wants to win this.
And at this point, I want to introduce you to our robot guru, Mr. Mark Satrakian, right up there.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce you to the pinnacle of fighting robots.
This is something I've been building towards for years, years of development for me and my career. I have put thousands of hours of my time into these machines. It's a live sporting event, which means that everything that happens, happens in real time. It's not scripted. And these machines have to work. And they have to beat the crap out of each other. The process of building these robots is very challenging.
Like a little explosion of white fire came shooting out of the side of it, which is not something you generally want to see.
This project is so ambitious because nothing like this has been done before. It is truly innovative.
There's hydraulic fluid at 2,000 pounds of pressure going into these robots through a steel alloy T-bar, which is the bloodline of the robot and helps with balance.
All of these were decisions that were made so that they could be fast and move with authority and be able to slam into each other with incredible force and not just keel over.
At this point of the process, I've actually got pieces of removing them now. The torso would be the first one.
Construction of the machines, the materials, the engineering of every single part, and the software and the control system, and all these pieces have to come together in exactly the right way. These machines are so powerful and so dangerous, if you were standing in the ring, it would be like standing in the middle of a car crash. Thousands of hours of work have gone into this moment. I created 12 robots, each one of them different, each one of them with its own personality. This is a new form of human support combined with machines. It's human and machine brought together.
Now it's time for man to meet machine. In just a few hours, each one of you are going to meet your individual fighting robot.
I don't know what to expect.
Here we go. I can't wait. I just am ready to go. Let's do this.
See you back here tonight.
Are you ready? Are you sure? It's time for man to meet machine. Devon, Rick, Russell, enter the arena. Meet your robot.
My name is Russell Tate. I've been working with robotics hazardous environments.
Right. How you doing, guys?
My name is Devon Rick Johnson. I'm from East Texas, and I'm very country to the heart.
It is time to meet your robots.
The robot looks just like me. Sleek and black and beautiful.
I love you.
Now it's time for Amanda and Sara to enter the arena and meet your robot.
My name is Amanda Lucas. I'm a professional MMA fighter and the daughter of George Lucas. I haven't gotten where I am in my career because of my dad. I've done it all on my own. My blood, sweat, and tears are left on that mat every day when I leave.
I'm so excited. Me too.
My name is Sara Daddario. I'm an engineer. I founded a program to inspire other kids by giving them the opportunity to actually get their hands dirty in electronics.
Meet your robot. Robohammer.
Oh, my God, I'm so excited.
Look how well it moves.
Giant metal fist. I want to go in and, like, break stuff.
DJ Fazlul, let's meet Drone Strike.
Some damage with those bad boys.
Viano and George, let me introduce the Steel Cyclone.
It's got like these torpedoes on the end of its arm.
Boom! Andrew and Ross, are you intimidated?
No, not at all. I was glad to hear my partner is an MMA fighter, but there are tough guys throughout the competition. Viano the Olympian and Dr. Robot, that's a team I don't want to face right away.
Meet your robot. And later, their first and most important challenge of the tournament, all leading up to the first Robot Combat League fight. Two teams, one moves on, the other goes home. It's your turn to enter the arena and meet your robot.
If the robot moves exactly like me, I'll win the show.
Never before have I seen a humanoid robot as large as a human being. This is what we've been waiting for. This is the moment.
Meet your robot. Act!
got great speed, the axe head's cool. Plus me driving the thing, it's like, that together, you're like the best robot.
Next up, Kyle and Ashley. This is steampunk. Yes. Heather and John, here we go. This is your robot, Medieval.
My name is Heather Knight. It is really fantastic to have a robot that is my knight in shiny armor. Hey, darling.
All right, so Chris and Diana, are you ready to meet your robot?
Yes.
You ready?
Yes.
Here it is, Scorpio!
I'm, like, blown away. I get to be a part of this thing. We have knives!
It's not about your background. It's about your skill at that moment. It's about how you work with your teammates. You could be the strongest MMA fighter, but when it comes down to it, we're fighting robots, not each other. And it has pink lights!
Father and daughter team, Amber and Dave, this is Crash!
I mean, looking at the roll cage on him, nobody's going to get through that.
Looking at the competition, and I see that there's some teams that I'm kind of worried about, and there's some teams I'm not worried about. Axe, Steel Cyclone, definitely. Crash, I mean, they just don't seem like this is where they're supposed to be.
Jeffrey and Paolo, welcome your robot, Commander.
Nice. He's amazing. It's like a walking tank.
It was awestruck. It was massive. It had huge armor and, most importantly, a big giant fist.
Well, it's been quite an adventure so far, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Now we're taking this competition to a whole new level. Tomorrow is your first power-up challenge. Get some rest, because this will determine your rank in the tournament. Here we go.
Nice to meet you.
When you learn to operate a robot for the first time, I don't just give you the keys and say, have a good time, kids. They're complex and expensive machines, so we start with taking baby steps with our sparring robots.
All right, that looks pretty good.
Feels comfortable?
Okay, good.
I can legitimately say that I'm the first NASA scientist to participate in a boxing match with a one-ton boxing robot.
This doesn't intimidate me any more than flying a helicopter. Experience always wins.
You can say it's always been a dream of mine to control a fully functional humanoid battle robot.
Being in control of this powerful machine is exhilarating. I've never had more fun. I would not give up the opportunity to fight with robots for nothing.
Show me a punch straight out. All right, that's getting there.
I was blown away.
All right, 2-1.
With the jockeys, some of them have excellent form. Others, it's a disaster.
So when I do this, it barely lifts its arm.
Left arm, shoulder rotor is not happening.
I broke it. I think I'm just really strong. That's all.
Welcome back, everybody. You're now one step closer to your first fight in the Robot Combat League tournament. Are you psyched up?
Yeah.
All right, great. Because tonight is a game changer.
I have no idea what to expect.
To determine the order of fights, you'll be competing in a power-up challenge right now. And what that means is that you'll be going against the clock, team by team, to land one single punch on our sparring robot that's controlled by the robot guru himself, Mr. Mark Sartrakian. Your goal is to land a punch to the yellow and black target in the center of the robot's chest. Mark's robot will not fight back, but it will be a moving target. And remember, the clock is ticking. The fastest team gets the first seed in the tournament and faces the slowest team.
There's a lot of pressure right now because we're about to be ranked 1 to 12.
One single punch determines your fate. Are you ready for the power-up challenge? Ashley and Kyle, you're up first.
Being the first one to go up nerve-wracking. Everyone is watching us.
Your time starts now.
When the power-up song started, I just drove forward, and it was up to Ashley to nail a solid punch directly to the center of his chest.
Great job!
We thought we did very good. It's one step closer for world domination.
Coming up.
Oh, right.
Rankings are determined for the tournament. And two teams battle it out in the first fight of the Robot Combat League.
Okay, so am I going to be facing
you should
outward?
You should face outward, yeah.
Annika is a curious person. This is the up and down,
right,
the
so
hip.
Right, so inches from the floor to the hips. That's speed.
She just asks questions about everything.
Now I just have to hold this here to keep his leg. I don't want to just, like, go crazy with step. I'm trying to, like,
is that good for him?
It's not bad. It's not a bad thing, too. Annika, you should be driving.
Okay, sorry.
To determine the order of fights, you'll be competing in a power-up challenge right now. You'll be going against the clock to land one punch. You'll be ranked fastest to slowest, and those rankings will determine who you fight first. Next up, Amanda and Sara. The time starts now.
I'm watching what the other teams are doing. I want to take some things that I've learned from fencing, from attack helicopter operations, precision, and the teamwork, and I'm going to apply this to make this as accurate as possible.
Put too much study on all of us here, huh?
Yeah, we do. So I look at Team Commander. They're very busy analyzing everything and taking notes.
It takes more than a notebook.
Every quarterback has his playbook, right? But I'm confident we're going to win this thing.
Keisha, Annika, let's go. Your time starts now.
Don't be timid. As long as we take a calculated hit, we'll definitely finish this power-up challenge quickly.
John and Heather, your time starts now. Gigi, Fazul.
All right.
Andrew Ross.
I'm feeling a lot of pressure.
Are you nervous?
I'm nervous now that I'm sitting here.
Go straight. Do it.
I'm kind of freaked out right now.
Yeah!
Diana just, like, sliced the plate off of the robot. It was incredible.
Yeah!
I think we can win this because we have a strategy to hit that target that no one's tried yet.
All right, Jeffrey and Paolo, your time starts now.
Our strategy is just to stick our arm out straight towards that target. They outsmarted the competition, but it was almost, you know, almost like a cop-out.
This is defensive.
That's not going to help him in the rest of the competition.
And we're happy to know that our strategy was good enough that people started using it.
I don't know what Jeff and Paolo are writing in that notebook of theirs, but whatever it is, it seems to be working. I am a little jealous that I didn't think of it first.
Vonrick and Russell, are you ready? Here we go.
Hey.
Vonrick's a tough contender. You know, he's a fighter. That guy kind of gets on people's nerves.
Let's try the Frankenstein.
Going to the left.
Biano and Dr. Robot.
We got it.
Oh, crap, this is timed. I get a little panicky under pressure. Are you ready?
Good.
You gonna do it?
Yeah.
All right. My biggest concern is I haven't mastered the controls of the feet as well as some of the other contestants.
Amber and Dave, your time starts now.
Amber and Dave seem like they're having some trouble coordinating in this challenge. The legs and the arms just don't seem to be in sync.
Oh,
she was just literally just flailing away.
Back, come on.
The top score and the bottom
score, we'll be in the first fight. We'd actually rather be in the middle of the pack because we want to see the other robots fight. Oh, man. What the hell? It's all right.
Wow.
All right, everyone. Now it's time to see where you all place in the tournament bracket. The team with the best time will be ranked number one and have the advantage of going up against the last place team in our first fight. We tabulated the results. The fastest and top ranked team is Team Steel Cyclone by Otto and George.
The first competition for Robot Combat League ever, and we won it.
George and Viano, you will be facing our lowest ranked team, and that team is father and daughter duo Amber and Dave, Team Crash. I really feel bad about coming in dead last. I really felt like I let Amber down. So here are the final times and rankings for the power-up challenge, which determines each team's place in the RCL bracket. The first fight of the preliminary round will be top seed Steel Cyclone versus the heavy underdog Crash. With each win, teams move on to the next round in hopes of making it all the way to the championship fight. Okay, everybody, our first fight is in 2 days, so it's time to start training. And remember, it's win or go home. Who's your favorite to win it all? Follow the tournament online at sci-fi.com. Coming up, it's the first ever fight of the Robot Combat League as the confident Team Steel Cyclone goes up against the father-daughter duo of Team Crash.
Kind of warming this robot up a little bit.
Yeah. I feel confident in George. I can tell he's a competitor. I can see some planning going on in his head.
If you start taking any hits, I'm going to back you off.
Yep.
And we'll see if we can get Amber into that flailing motion.
Panic mode.
And then we'll come back in and
be aggressive.
Be aggressive.
Good.
I'm not afraid of breaking a robot.
I started a robot building center. I wanted to teach kids technology, and it's really hard to learn. But when they get into robots, it's cool. It's fun.
Engage. You're all set.
Steel Cyclone is a sleek, futuristic-looking machine. It fits perfectly with Biano's exceptional athleticism and George's expertise in robotics. If they can leverage these talents in the arena, they will be successful.
We know we have to be in sync.
It's very unusual to try to move your legs with your hands, and also taking an Olympic hurdler and making him into a fighter.
I mean, who has experience fighting robots, really? I don't think any of us do.
You know what? You're right. You have to be careful. You can tip over.
He's bouncing quite a bit, which could cause some damage.
When things break and the robot humbles over, I almost feel like my own body is starting to humble over a little bit.
I'm going
to
go down and check it out. Okay, yeah. This guy's actuator is broken, and he's not even going to get a chance to fight unless we get it fixed.
Actually broke. It's not like the hose popped off.
I feel like I'm cursed right now. I mean, my Achilles got banged up at the Olympics in 2008, and now my Achilles is messed up on my robot. I'm a two-time Olympian, and I ran for Panama. I got fifth place at the Athens Games, but it's semifinals of 2008 in Beijing. I had an Achilles injury. It was over, you know? It was over. If this happens to us in the fight, that's gonna be it.
Can I go ahead and hook right in? So we're wondering, that other one was bouncing around quite a bit.
That's just him driving.
One of our big strategies is to know our robot, know our armor, and know our opponent's robot. Let me try a few range of motion things.
Okay. Okay.
All right, go ahead and walk.
Team Crash isn't really that coordinated yet.
Yeah, he seems to sway a lot.
Yeah, this is making me nervous.
Can you, you know, a real person, when they walk, they tilt their body in compensation.
That's a good speed and a good step size. I'm not worried about throwing anything off doing that.
Amber and I have a special bond. We have a special relationship.
That might work. In college, I got really sick. While I was having my kidney problems, my dad was diagnosed with throat cancer. Okay, let's try walking forward while I throw a few.
Really, it was pulling together as a family. It helped us all through it.
Ready, go.
We're father and daughter. The other other competition has to watch out for us, because at the end of the day, blood is thicker than hydraulic fluid. I think that Bino and George's strategy is going to be to come out strong.
Yeah, put pressure on him, man, because right now he's okay, but he's not going to know how to react.
Olympic athlete, he's going to come out with power. He's going to immediately try to charge us. We're going to counter that by charging him right back. They don't expect that. Hey, George, be afraid.
Stop it. They can't hear you.
Be afraid.
They're just trying to hype himself up. That's great.
I'm ready to go. Let's do this.
As the teams make their final preparations for battle.
We gotta win this thing.
Yeah, I can't wait now. Jump on that robot so bad.
We're the team to beat.
They're coming in here at last place, but we're favored to win.
Dave is maybe being soft because he's like protecting his daughter.
That makes sense.
Yeah. Crash does kind of look like a bunch of scrap metal put together from the wrecked Jeep and make a robot. So we're pretty confident we're gonna be able to take it out.
I'm gonna drive you right in.
Throw me right into the fray. Yeah, man.
We didn't do so well in the challenge. That doesn't matter. That's irrelevant. We're going to come in hard today. We're going to be competitive. We're going to be strong.
Feeling a little sorry for Biano and George right now. We really wanted to do better on that challenge. But on the other hand, we learned a lot. We learned a lot of the mistakes, I think, that other people didn't learn. It's going to really help us.
We'll run forward at them and then kind of crouch down right before. And I'll swing in and pull right up. They'll be a little off balance. And then we can follow through with maybe a nice hook and, you know, go from there.
I feel sorry for their pretty little blue robot.
Yeah,
we're gonna mess it up.
It's gonna not look so nice at the end. It's gonna be kind of sad looking.
Coming up. 3, 2, 1. The top seed, Steel Cyclone, takes on the underdog Crash. Win or go home. Number 12 seed Team Crash taking on the top seed Team Steel Cyclone, with the winner moving on in the tournament. Amber and Dave into the arena.
I've never really been in a real fight before.
We're the first fighters. Nobody's ever taken these robots and actually come together like this. And to be able to control this magnificent beast with this kind of huge power. It's just incredible.
Bionno and George, enter the arena.
We're definitely favored to win the fight. We won the power-up challenge. Fight's definitely going our way.
Crash robot looks pretty powerful, but we're going to knock it down.
Woo! Here we go.
Tonight.
This is it. Now, you've been fighting, training hard for this moment. You have watched each other, but now it's real. Okay? Father and daughter team, Amber and David, who's going to win this first?
Yeah.
But you guys finished last in the power-up challenge.
Yep, irrelevant. Steel Cyclone, don't get overconfident. We're coming for you.
We've already scored first in the power-up challenge.
They broke their robot in about 2 seconds.
Yeah, there's a level. Oh, you hear that?
We're ready.
Wow, sister's got some attitude.
No, it's okay. I don't expect much from them at this point. They're coming in here at last place.
You know what's at stake? $100,000.
That's what this fight
is. $100,000. Will be yours, but first you have to win this fight. You guys ready to go?
Ready to go.
All right, go to your battle station, you guys. Dave, over to you. Let's keep it going.
Thank you very much, Chris. My name is Dave Farah. I am your color commentator for the very first Robot Combat League tournament. And tonight we have two radically different teams. All right, Team Crash is coming in at 7 feet 9 inches and has a distinct height and weight advantage, but Steel Cyclone holds the important advantage of reach. Top-ranked Steel Cyclone is sleek and compact. His torpedo fists are like ball-peen hammers on steroids. Any way it hits you, it's gonna hurt. And the father-daughter duo of Team Crash is RCL's walking crash test dummy. The Cro-Moly steel cage is nearly indestructible, but doesn't absorb impact, and a solid hit right to the roll cage sends the impact right to the bone. What do you think of tonight's matchup? Tell us on Twitter using hashtag RobotCombat. Chris, back over to you. Everybody, this is Crash will be taking on the Steel Cyclone. Started, let's take a look at the rules. Fights consist of 3 2-minute rounds. 3 ringside judges score the action to determine a winner. Points are awarded to strong, solid hits to vital parts. Teams have a pit crew in 20 minutes to make all necessary repairs. Judges can stop a round early due to excessive damage, and robots can be knocked out if they aren't able to make the bell for the next round. Cyclone.
That was just a massacre.
What a fight, though. Okay, let's take a look at the replay here. That big right hand to the body, and then you see that upper arm of Crash comes breaking free, and right away, Steel Cyclone starts wailing away on that exposed actuator, and just like that, hydraulic fluid starts spraying everywhere.
Not good. Look at that. All right, let me out. Come on. Clock's ticking. Go, clock's ticking.
Crash is at standstill. What'll happen is they're going to have 20 minutes to take their robot, repair it, and if they're not able to restart it, it'll be a TKO victory for Steel Cyclone.
The horn sounded. Our robot was clearly disabled. I flew out of that harness as fast as I could and started trying to figure out what the damage was and if we'd be able to repair it in time.
Oh, what are we doing?
You gotta get the actuator out. It's gonna be a tough 20 minutes. Losing an actuator basically means that our arm is dead.
We either pull this actuator
or just lock it in place.
That's
a really big blow for us. It's really hard to fight one arm.
Man, we got some damage.
It's purely cosmetic. That thing is completely busted, and it's busted on the hard end to fix.
Yeah.
Dave and Amber were so confident in the pre-match.
They weren't intimidated by the fact that they were the big underdog coming in against the favorites, the top ranked.
But let's call a spade a spade. They finished last in the Power Up Challenge, so you could call them underdogs or just call them the worst team in the pack.
Oh, this is all their blood on us. Yeah. I'm seeing blue in here thinking, what's leaking? That's all them.
We won that round without a doubt.
Without a doubt. Without a doubt.
Round one goes to Team Cycling.
I got it.
Are you just taking it off completely?
I'm just pulling it off because it's too badly damaged to
right.
We have to get that actuator out, get it replaced, get all the armor tightened up.
All right. Nice. We got our actuator back in.
We get that actuator out and put a second one in, but I've got a piece of armor that's broken off.
We gotta get this back on.
We need a screw like this, but longer.
No, that's not gonna work. You gotta take that screw out, take that out, put a new screw through the whole thing.
Fast.
It's hitting right up here.
Do you think we'll finish this in time?
There's no way we can repair it in time.
1 minute remains.
We're really screwed. We gotta get this back on, because otherwise we're really screwed.
Yeah, our arm is dead, and it's really hard to fight one arm. So we have to repair the robot before the 20-minute time is up.
25 minutes.
All right. So what happened to Crash?
Well, it looks like happened. The armor got ripped off. When we were all tangled up in there, the actuator got pulled as well. This damage was an accident.
So
honestly,
if you can get Crash fixed up here and get back out there.
I think we'll be good to go.
Amber, come here, man.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm hoping we don't lose too many tight, because I think this is loose. We have the screws? Here, got it. I was worried at first about getting it replaced on time.
We're done.
Okay, perfect.
2, 1.
I can't believe we just fixed this robot. Dad, we're going into the ring to kick some ass.
I can see her out of the corner of my eye, and I can see how she's moving. And just from that, I can anticipate her moves. That will make the difference in this fight.
We're going to go out there and repeat what we did in the first round. Rip off another arm.
All right, here we go. After round 2, help me out here. 3, 2. Incapacitated right now. Let's take a look at the replay. Just when you think Steel Cyclone is winning the fight, Team Crash pulls it together and dominates early on in round 2.
Team Crash broke their own arm, but they're getting the job done. Amber and Dave went for the core, and that was the strategy. Amber and Dave, Biano and George. Come on out here, guys. Wow, the head of Steel Cyclone.
And the winner? By second round knockout, Amber and Dave.
Congratulations. You are the winners. Biano and George, you guys did an amazing job.
Thank you so much. You guys were great.
You guys
took
the face of the arena, taking the head of Steel Cyclone.
Our first round was pretty strong, but they got some good shots in, and they incapacitated our robot.
That's it.
Great fight. Congratulations, guys. You make it to round 2.
I'm the first woman to ever compete in this competition. And not only did we win, but we beat the crap out of them.
Two of us, father and daughter, together doing this thing, it was amazing.
Congratulations. You'll be moving on to round 2. Awesome job. Ladies and gentlemen, your winners.